You know, let me put another perspective on the cloud. I think Mr. Satyanarayan, in his own indefatigable way, gave it a very human face, saying culturally it should work for India because we're used to sharing number of people in the car, number of people who use an internet connection. And he was giving the analogy of how cloud is normally not used in good connotations. So I should say, in some ways, we should be in India the first to really adopt the cloud, because for a country that so depends on the monsoons, who else should adopt the cloud? And in some ways, you know, cloud as a concept has been there as long as I remember. When I started my career with IBM, and you only had mainframes, everybody wanted the cloud. That was called a data center. You wanted to focus on your application and you didn't want to buy the infrastructure. Except there wasn't the need for on-demand computing. There wasn't the sophistication that was needed in management. And there wasn't the technology that allowed you to do it. The good thing today is that we pretty much have the technology. There will be bits and pieces that will keep coming. But we have the technology today for cloud to be a reality. And a few years ago, I know many of us in the IT industry used to get this funny look if people said, oh, is this the next thing that you chaps are starting, like the Y2K? Nobody says that today. And for us, I think it's very critical, some of the things that I was just hearing, very critical for us to get it right, because as a country, we have not yet made the real heavy investments in infrastructure. An IT infrastructure that the developed world has done. And therefore, we have the most to gain by leveraging cloud at its earliest. So we do not make those heavy investments and then look at how we will actually optimize those investments. So the time for us is right. And the benefit from the cloud, which is inherently that you can focus on the applications, you reduce your cost, because you don't have to invest in infrastructure, you can use it optimally. You're much quicker to deploy on your time, the urgency which we have. Those are very critical for a country like India, because if you look today, some of our biggest challenges, whether it's public distribution, for example, the leakage in that, whether you look at the fact that we only have about a third as many teachers as we need, or if you look at only half as many people who have access to affordable healthcare. All of these, today technology and applications can be used to sort them out for ourselves. But there is urgency, there is limited availability of capital. And so for us to see where all we can leverage cloud is important, because if I look at government, which is taking a big lead in this, there is no government application that really cannot leverage the cloud. And in many ways, compared to other countries, I think it is appropriate that we begin to lead in the different models, in the different structures. I mean, we have a complex country, 35 states and union territories. For us, the ability for what has been done when in one state to be leveraged in another. For us, to be very mindful of how optimally we use our infrastructure. For us, to look at how fast we can deploy what is needed is more critical than most countries that I know. And therefore, it is, I think, very appropriate for us, as we go forward, from what I hear right now and others, is to develop the models that other countries will follow. And I think the institutional frameworks are very key. How do you have vendor neutrality? How do you ensure that they will continue to be interoperability? Because these things, once they get set, become very, very hard to change. So if you simply look at other examples in the US on healthcare, it is so hard in the US now to look at changing this whole thing on health records because there aren't standards. In a country like India, where we haven't really gotten very far, you can actually change standards. So standards would know, state standards on how the state would collaborate, for instance. Standards on how you will create accountability on people, vendors, and others who supply. Many, many of these, and then there are several others. How do you create institutional frameworks, how do you create standards, will determine how successful all of this is going to be. So I would only say, I think technology is a piece of it, and I think technology providers, like CA and many others, are clearly making that happen, and I think we have enough today to make it work. Technology always keeps improving. But I think the focus now is on how we build institutional frameworks, how we build governance frameworks, how we build collaboration frameworks, and really look at how we then make this reality in real life. Thank you.